Welcome to this introductory lesson. This might be the first time you've ever taken your laser out of the case, and today we just want to go over the basics. We will build on your knowledge more later. Today, in our example, we have a set of cabinets that are in our office that happen to be in a corner, and we want you to find something that you can follow along with, whether that means you take a desk and place it where two walls meet. Anything rectangular will work. In a pinch, grab a big box from an Amazon shipment, put something heavy in there so it doesn't move, and shove it in a corner. You'll be able to follow along. But today we're gonna go over setting up the tripod, securing the laser to that tripod. We'll launch the software for the first time. There's a little bit of setup there. Then we'll tell the system what height we're capturing. We call this setting the plane. We'll capture the front edges of your rectangle, and then we'll measure the details of the wall, including the corner. Walls are never quite perfectly straight, and we're gonna see that in action today. Then we'll have you measure a point on the front of your rectangle that might represent a sink cutout. Let's say an undermount sink. You wanna know how far away from that side wall it might be. And then we're gonna check your measurements. It's important that you're confident with what you have on the screen, and that it matches the reality in front of you. Practice this a few times, and when we're ready, we'll move on to the next lessons. First, unlock the top tripod leg lock. You'll extend this leg fully and then close to re-engage the lock. Now you'll do the same with each of the other legs. Open the lock, extend the leg fully, close to engage the lock. Now, you'll spread open the tripod legs completely and set the tripod on stable footing. It's a good idea to take this silver T-bolt and point it in the direction of your work area. Take the laser, place this pin securely into the top of the tripod head. Gently rotate the black fine adjust knob back towards you just above the tablet mount. Use this T-shaped bolt and give it a little torque. This will secure the laser in the tripod, so make sure it's nice and tight. Next, you will power on your tablet and use the tablet mount pin and place it in the top of the tripod here. You will need an internet connection the first time you launch LT3 Raptor. On the tablet, start the app, and then you'll enter your email and password that you use to set up your LPI Cloud account. Flip on this Remember Me switch. This will keep you logged in whenever you do not have an internet connection out in the field. The first time you access LT3, your initial setup will be guided by our setup wizard. In North America, you'll use inches and fractions. Most of the rest of the world, you'll use millimeters. This screen is all about the layout of your buttons. We recommend the LT3 layout as this will follow along with our training videos. Next is the app output folder. For most users, you'll use the documents folder. This is just the place where all of your jobs will be exported to by default. Press select folder. We'll press next one last time. This brings us to the synchronize settings page. For the vast majority of users, we recommend the default settings. On the home screen, press New Job, type in Practice Job, and we recommend adding your name and the date. Verify the calibration switch is turned on every time you plan on connecting the laser. Press Add. Once we are in the template screen at the top, you'll see the system is searching for the laser. It has not been plugged in yet. Go ahead and connect the USB cable into the tablet, then press the power button. You'll see the green light turn on, and in just a moment, you'll see the connection pop up. This is a reminder every time to make sure the two dots are aligned and the 2D lock is engaged. This is a spring-loaded pin that can be pulled and rotated out to allow for smooth up and down movement. Again, the 2D lock must be engaged when you initialize the laser. This ensures accurate measurements. Next, if there are any areas the laser cannot see directly, set up a target. In this case, we're using a T-target that represents the edge of this cabinet. We've got one in the front. Let's go ahead and place one along the back. Now the laser has something to hit that is aligned with the edge of this cabinet. You can now disengage the 2D lock to allow for that vertical up and down movement. We recommend what we call a dry run. Just point the laser around your workspace and make sure the laser has something to hit along the walls and along the edges of, in this case, cabinets, but whatever you have set up in front of you. You'll either have white or black targets that we will use to set the plane. Set them up in a triangle shape, one on the left, one on the right, and one in the back. This triangle shape will become very familiar every time you set up the laser in a new area to measure. We always shoot in this order to define the height that we are capturing. Let's start with the target on the left. Align the laser anywhere along this top line. Tap in the drawing area to create that first measurement. Once you hear the sound, move the laser to the second target. Capture your second plane point. Then capture the middle back plane point. Now the system knows what height we are measuring and we're ready to start capturing the geometry. Use capture line and we'll be in the cabinets color. At this point, come up to mode and we recommend going into auto fillet. Now, aim the laser. In this case, on the front left. Tap anywhere in the empty drawing area of your screen, and this will capture your first point. Now move the laser along the front face of what you're measuring. In this case, we're going to the right. Tap on the screen again, and that second point creates your first line. Move the laser up, in this case to the targets. As you capture the next two points, you'll get another line in an auto fillet mode. It will connect that corner automatically. You can see this drawing represents what is in front of us. We are still in capture, in line. I'm going to change our color, also known as an edge style, to represent our wall. And we will change to our continuous line capture mode. Move your laser to the wall. Tap on your screen. That'll capture the first wall point. Now move every about 6 to 12 inches to capture or scribe the details of this wall. As you get close to the corner, we recommend capturing about 3 inches away from the corner. Then we drill the corner to capture the detail of the mud in the drywall corner. Continue to scribe along that wall to capture the wall's details. And you will finish along the front of the cabinet. We've captured the basic shape. Next, we will capture a center line. Tap on the line that represents the front face, the direction, usually this will be up. Make a mark on your front cabinet. Then line up the laser on your mark that represents where your center line would go. Tap on the screen to capture the measurement. We want to close these gaps on the right side. Press fillet. We will connect the corners by selecting anywhere along one wall. Then select the adjacent edge. Again, we'll click on the other wall and connect the other cabinet face. Now those cabinet lines are the correct length. Click on distance and dimensions. We can quickly see the dimensions available.
Once you have these dimensions on your screen, grab your tape measure, put the tape from the wall along your front edge, and in this case, we'll see our measurement line up with the T-target. This T-target represents this edge of the cabinet, or the entire front length of what we've measured. We'll follow the same process with the back. Put the tape measure directly in the corner. come all the way out to check what you measured with the laser. You should be pretty darn close.
Our tolerance is 1/16 of an inch or 1.5 millimeters.
We will do the same with the right hand edge from the wall to the front face of the cabinet. That is where we shot our laser point. Now we will check the left end. Tape measure all the way to the wall. Remember, we drilled the corner here. After we check our perimeter dimensions, we should see that what we fabricate will fit correctly. Now we will check the centerline measurement. In the LT3 measuring software, use distance and the parallel tool. Pick one segment of the centerline and then the wall it's closest to. Now, check that with your tape, and you should have an accurate dimension. So at this point, you should have measurements on your screen that match the shape in front of you. Good job. Practice this a few times. Commit this to memory. And then we'll continue to build on your knowledge in the next lessons. Thank you.